Hello students, so we'll start with our second unit, which is forecasting room availability. For your easier understanding, this unit has been divided into the following six sections. So let us just understand what all six sections are we going to study about. The first section is introduction to forecasting room availability. In the next section, we are going to learn about the benefits of forecasting. The third unit will consist of the information required for a forecasting formality to be done. In the fourth section, we are going to talk about a 10 days pattern, a 3 days pattern, basically information required, a pattern which we have to take a note of. We'll move on to our fifth subtopic and we'll discuss about evaluating front office operations. In here, we'll talk in details about the DOR, which is daily operations report. Then we'll talk about occupancy percentage, occupancy ratio. And in the sixth chapter, which is your conclusion, we'll talk about the various formulas, which is AGR, AHR, then we'll talk about ARR, ADR. So all of this information will be given to you. Kindly note all of the formulas in your journal. So that's basically just about the six subtopics that you are going to study about. And so let's just start with you. So we'll continue with our unit 2. And the first subtopic for you will be forecasting. Let us understand what forecasting means. Also the definition. Forecasting means to say what will probably happen in near future. Hence, it is a prediction of future happening based on data available. So, in simple words, it is a process of understanding or estimating the future business of a hotel. So, the next part of your second units is benefit. Now that we have understand what forecasting it, let us just go through the benefits of it. The first point would be it helps in projecting future rooms that a hotel can provide and the revenue that it can generate from the room sales. It will also help in management to make a manpower. The third point would be that it facilitates inventory management of other departments too. Other departments meaning housekeeping, F&B service, maybe production, every other department, sales, purchase, materials, every department. The fourth point would be that allocation of resources to provide best customer service so that we can have a glimpse of how many footfall would be there at the hotel. We are easily able to understand what all sections do we need to have a focus on, so that the shift can run smoothly. The fifth point would be that it helps reservation manager to take selective overbooking based on reservation forecast. So you see, forecasting is not just important for just the front office team, but for every other department. It is needed for every department to run smoothly. With that, we finish the second part, which is benefits of forecasting. We'll now move on to the third part, which is the information required. So for forecasting to happen smoothly, there are certain informations that we need. Let us just move on to the third part and understand what are important factors, what all notifications do we have to understand forecasting as a whole. Now let us move on to the third part of your second unit. Like I had informed in the earlier video that there are certain informations required for a forecasting to happen. Let us understand what all points do we need to take a note on. Number one would be a thorough knowledge of rooms and rate.
rooms and rate meaning the different categories, the different types, the different rate methods that the reservation team can, you know, facilitate in charging the guest. Number two would be a perfect judgment of what can happen in the near future. And this judgment doesn't come spending 1 or 2 or 3 years in a particular hotel. It happens through a years of practice, okay, specially taken care by the front office manager. The next one would be profile of target market hotel can cover. Now you already know what target market is, that's already been discussed in the previous unit. So if in case you forget, just go back and take a look. So let's just again understand in depth what all information are required. Other details that we need to take care for forecasting of rooms would be percentage of no-shows, the number of people who are not turning up, percentage of overbooking. So it's the duty of a front office manager or the reservations team in a situation wherein the hotel sales is a little low, they do overbooking just to, you know, pacify, just to cover up the losses. The next would be future plans of renovation of the hotel room. So we'll have to understand, say suppose, which is the perfect time to, if there's a makeover needed at any hotel room, or there is, you know, some sort of servicing of a furniture or a fixture, or, you know, there's a problem in the, there's leakage in a room, or anything that has to be fixed can be done at a certain time where in the hotel there's not much of a guest, and, you know, we can take a maybe 4, 5, 6 rooms at a particular time, and the servicing can be done without any hindrance of a shift. Also, the cancellation statistics, there'll be a pattern wherein you see there'll be 4 to 5 cancellations happening every day. Keeping that in mind, we'll have to take care of the overbookings, take care of the OS rooms, that is out of service room. There'll be rooms which is out of order. So all of this has to be kept in mind. With that, we'll finish on our third part, and we'll move on to the fourth part and talk in details about all of these four information. We shall move on to the fourth subtopic of your second unit. We'll talk about in details about the four parts that we had discussed in the previous video on information required for room forecasting. The first heading is records required for the room forecasting availability. The forecasting of room availability requires a lot of effort from the reservation managers in the hotel. Also, the front office manager comes in part in this as well. It requires a lot of information from the past trends. So there's a trend that is followed, say, about a year or 2 year policy, a 5 year policy. So that has to be kept in account. The number of check-in on each day during the same period. So nothing very difficult. It's very easy to understand. We shall move on to the next one. So for understanding these data, there are certain pointers that we have to keep in mind. What are they? They are number of walk-in guests. Walk-in guest meaning guests coming in at the hotel without any reservation or without any prior information. Okay, they just walk in. Number of understays. So suppose my reservation is for 2 days, but I stay only for 1 day and I cancel my reservation for the other day, but I have already paid for the same. So the hotel will not lose any revenue, but my stay is decreased. So that is understay. Number of overstay. Similarly, if my reservation is for 1 day, but I plan to make a change and stay at the hotel for 2 days, that's overstaying. The fourth one would be number of departures. Number of departures at a particular shift. Number of no-shows. people or guests who are not turning up. Number of cancellations. Okay? Simple. People who cancel, guests who cancel their reservation. Now, suppose I need the percentages for calculation. We need percentages. How will we do that? We shall take out percentage of, say, suppose walk-in guest by calculating or dividing the total number of walk-in guests with the total number of arrivals and multiplying it by 100. Simple mathematics. So the higher the percentage of walk-in guest, it makes difficult for the hotel to forecast of room availability. Number of no-shows, the percentage of no-shows. If a guest with confirmed reservation doesn't turn up the hotel on the date of arrival, it is called as no-show. The percentage of no-show helps the front office manager to early release of guest room. With this, we finish the fourth part of our video. This fourth subtopic will be divided into two sections. This is section number one, and then we can continue with section number two, continuing with the story of information required for room forecasting. So this is part two of section number four. We shall move on to the topic percentage of overstay. So how do we calculate that? Let's just understand what's overstay first. The guests who stay more and extend their stay of departure are called overstays. Okay? It results in making the room availability low for that period. So in this kind of condition, hotel expects in the lean season or hotels running on low occupancy can favor the guest by extending their stay also. The calculation of percentage of overstay is done wherein we'll have to divide the number of overstays room by the number of expected checkout, and that's how we shall get percentage of overstay. Similarly, percentage of understay will be calculated by dividing the number of understay room divided by number of expand checkout. Okay, with this we end this topic of information required for calculating forecasting rooms. So by understanding all of these terms, this will help us in forecasting marketing strategies and to earn revenue for the hotels. But nowadays hotels focuses more on revenue management along with customer satisfaction. That is the key goal for every hotel. We'll now talk about a 10-day forecast. Before that, just understand what a forecast form needs. So it is prepared by the front office, also several other departments depending on its need. Occupancy forecasts are typically developed on a monthly basis and reviewed by food and beverage and rooms divisions manager to forecast revenue, project expenses and develop labor schedule. So what is a 10 days forecast now? A 10-day forecast at most lodging properties is developed jointly by the front office manager and the reservations manager. So that's basically the FO team. Okay, possibly in junction with a forecast committee. So maybe there's a F&B manager, the housekeeping manager. They can also be a part of this core committee. A 10-day forecast usually consists of daily forecast occupancy figures, including room arrivals, room departures, room sold and number of guests. Okay, that's very much needed. The second point would be that the number of group committee with the listing of each group's name, arrival and departure dates. So maybe 2-3 months prior only we get an information for any group arrival. So we make a note, the reservations team make a note, and the information is passed on to the front office manager and other department heads. So the what all details like number of room reserved, name of the guest, number of guests and quoted room rates if it's needed, okay? Needed for housekeeping also, if there is a specific amenity to be placed, or the F&B team also, if you know, there are certain packages that they have, if breakfast is included or not, and what all items maybe are supposed to be placed in the room in case of food and beverage, that is also taken care of. A comparison of the previous periods forecasted and actual room counts and occupancy percentage. So a special 10-day forecast must be prepared for the food and beverage, banquet, catering operations also. So this forecast will usually help us in understanding the expected number of guests, and we can run our shift or you know, the month properly with proper you know, people, proper manpower to help us have this shift run smoothly. Similarly, we also have a 3-day forecast. So 3-day forecast will be more accurate, will have more details, forecasting an updated report that reflects more current estimate room availability. A 3-day forecast is intended to guide management in fine-tuning of labor schedule and adjusting room availability information. So students, now we'll understand how to evaluate front office operations. There are certain, you know, important tools, important formulas that we'll have to take care, and this is needed by the front office team on an everyday basis. So let's understand what is this. Evaluating results for front office operation is an important management function. The operation managers of front office attains a planned goal wherein they will have to evaluate certain results and activities on a daily, monthly, quarterly and an yearly basis. Important tools that are needed would be a daily operation report, DOR, it's called DOR. Then there's occupancy ratios, what is the occupancy for the particular day, room revenue analysis, hotel's income, room division income statement, room divisions budget reports, operation ratios and standards. Let us understand what is a DOR or daily operation report. The daily operation report is known as the manager's report or a daily report. The daily report revenue is a revenue report. Contains the hotel's financial activities during a 24-hour period, as in for the particular day. The daily operation report is uniquely structured to meet the individual need of hotel properties. Room statistics, occupation ratios form an entire section of a typical daily report. The information provided by the daily operations report is not restricted to the front office manager or the hotel general manager. The copies of the daily operation reports are generally distributed to all departments. So for example, housekeeping, F&B service and you know, production also, so that they can understand, they can analyze, they can redefine and estimate a budget. Moving on to occupancy ratio. An occupancy ratio measures the success of a front office in selling the hotel's primary product, that is, a guest room. The following room statistics must be gathered to calculate basic ratios such as number of room available for sale, number of rooms sold, number of guests per room, net room revenue. Generally, these data are contained on the daily operations report and can be computed these data into occupancy percentage, average daily rate, which is ADR, or occupancy, that is the double occupancy ratio, and average rate per guest. The night auditor, typically it's the work of a night auditor who collects all the information and calculates occupancy ratio, while the front office manager analyzes the information to
identify a trend, pattern, or if there is any problem which the hotel is facing. This is the last section of your second unit, which is in here we'll talk about ADR, which is average daily rate, and ARG, average rate per guest. That's the formula of ADR, and this is the formula of AGR. Let me just explain what is this. So ADR, most front office managers calculate an average daily rate through room rates with a property varying significantly from single room to suites, from individual guests to group and conventions, from weekdays to weekend, from a busy to a slack season. And how is ADR calculated? ADR is calculated by dividing the room revenue by number of rooms sold. So let's understand what a special note is given here. Some hotels include complimentary room in the denominator to show the true effect of complimentary rooms and an ADR. Sometimes this is called average house rate, okay? In case this happens, wherein a complimentary room is featured, then it will be called as average house rate, AHR. Now we'll shift on to average rate per guest. Resort hotels in particular are often interested in knowing the average room rate per guest. So basically needed by a resort hotel, particularly they use this. This rate is normally based on every guest in the hotel, including children. Okay, average rate per guest would be room revenue by number of guests. Okay. So you can just understand, just go through and write all of this formulas in your front office journal, okay?
So student, with this we finished our second unit, which is forecasting room availability.
So students, we'll understand forecasting data. Let me just tell you, these are the pointers that you need to take care when you are understanding forecasting data. We'll shift our next topic to calculating percentage of no-shows. So the formula says percentage of no-shows would be equal to the number of no-show rooms by the number of room reservations. Say for example, the number of no-shows for today would be 5, okay? And the total number of room reservation for today is 15. If you calculate that, the value would come as 0.3%, okay? And that is your percentage of no-shows. Similarly, if we take in other topics, which is percentage of walk-ins, that is percentage of walk-ins would be equal to the number of room walk-ins by the total number of room arrivals. Percentage of overstays would be number of overstay rooms by number of expected checkouts. Percentage of understay would be number of understay rooms by number of expand checkout. So how do we calculate now a room forecast, as in forecasting of room availability? That would be total number of guest room minus number of out of order rooms minus number of room stay over minus number of room reservation plus number of room reservation percentage, number of room understays minus number of overstays. Okay, this is your formula for forecasting room availability.